Dear friends, in this session, we'll discuss about location of cardinal points in a thick lens. As discussed, these are the cardinal points in a thick lens, P1, P2, F1 and F2. Then, locating this second principal point, is at a distance P2D from the second refracting surface. Therefore, from triangles BCI and GDI and H2, P2, F2 and GDF2, we have this P2D divided by P2, F2 is equal to H2G by H2, F2 is equal to BG by GI. This is equal to CD by CI. And this CD is nothing but the thickness of the lens, and this CI is nothing but the image distance of the first refracting surface. Therefore, from the last two terms, P2D is equal to P2 F2 into D by V1. Since this distance is measured in opposite direction to the incident light, therefore this is taken negative here. This is equal to, this is nothing but F2, this is T, and 1 by V1. This equation was discussed in the previous session. Therefore, 1 by V1 is equal to mu minus 1 by mu into R1. Substituting this equation in this, we get beta is equal to minus F into mu minus 1 into T divided by mu into R1. Meaning that this second principal point is at this distance from the second refracting surface at a point D. Yes. Similarly, the first principal point is located at a distance of CP1 is equal to alpha from the first refracting surface, and it is similar to that followed in the second principal plane. Now, to locate this second focal point from these triangles, we have DF2 by P2 F2 is equal to DI by CI. Therefore, DF2 is equal to F into DI by CI. DI is nothing but CI minus AD. Simplify this, we get this. Therefore, F is equal to 1 minus T by V1. But we know that 1 by V1 is equal to mu minus 1 by mu into R1. Substitute this in this equation, we get this. DF2 is equal to F into 1 minus mu minus 1 into T divided by mu into R1. This gives you the location of the second focal point. Meaning that this second focal point is at this distance from the second refracting surface. Similarly, to locate the first focal point, the light ray is incident from the other direction now. And when the direction is changed, definitely the positions of R1 and R2 interchange, and also the signs become opposite. And following the same procedure, we get CF1 is equal to minus F into 1 plus mu minus 1 into T divided by mu into R2. And regarding this power of thick lens, P is equal to 1 by F as derived in the previous session. 1 by F is equal to this one. Then on rearranging this, we get P is equal to P1 plus P2 minus P1 P2 into T by mu. This is the power of the lens. And the recap is all about equivalent focal length of a system, and then location of cardinal points in a thick lens. Yes, and these are the references I have made use in this video. And lastly, I would like to thank you all for watching this video.